welcome on Aruba and welcome on my mommy channel. A lot of you guys are so interested in why I picked Aruba to live and what I really love about Aruba. So today I thought I'm gonna make a video for you guys and tell you what I love about Aruba. And also some things that I wish we had on Aruba, but let's just start with everything that I love because there's so much to talk about. First of all, well, you could have guessed the weather here on Aruba, because all year long it's super nice weather. Okay, of course we have rainy season, but it's still so warm. Can you imagine that you never, never, ever have to wear a jacket? I hate wearing jackets, and sometimes your jacket is too warm and then you take it off and it's too cold. Here on Aruba, you don't need it. It's just so perfect. You can always be outside. You never have to get cold, even though I do have a cold, but that's from the air conditioning, because that one is really cold. Also, the beaches here on Aruba, they are so amazing. And if you guys watch our vlogging channel, we go to the beach sometimes. A little bit less now that Orlando is here, but the sand on the beaches here is so white. And the beaches of Aruba, especially Eagle Beach, has been chosen to be one of the most beautiful beaches of the whole world. So think about that. Mm-hmm. And the whole north side of Aruba is just beach, 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 beach. And because Aruba is so small, it's so easy to get to. It's just, I love it. I love getting a tan. I love lying in the sand, taking a dip in the water. And the water is so blue and see-through. I just love that. Also, the people here on Aruba, they are so lovable. They want to help you all the time. Okay, you have to be a little bit interested in the island and tell and show your love. And then as soon as you, for example, show a little bit of your language in Aruba, say, Kotabai or Buen dia, good morning. Just the small things, you know. People here just love it. And then they just open up to you and they are so warm-hearted. And they take you in their houses. And for example, with Mitchell's parents and his family, they are so close that they would all just go and lie in the same bed together, even though everybody is grown up here. And I come from Holland, where the people are a little bit more stiff, you know, that's not something I'm used to. So it was kind of weird in a sense for me first, but I would just jump in the bed with his parents right now too. So it's just, that's the way the people are here. They're so lovable. What I love more is the carnival here on Aruba. The carnival, it takes like 3 months. Of course, the preparation starts way earlier. But we have lightning parades. We have the parades where everybody who doesn't dress up can go. It's Juve morning. Of course, we have the big parades, the kinder parades. And you can really compare it, that's my opinion, you can really compare it to the carnival in Brazil. Of course, it's way smaller, but the costumes, they are so colorful and beautiful, and the music, you know, and there's always a competition in who's making the best music. And Mitchell's best friend, he also makes music for the carnival. It's just, I love that. It's in Holland, when it's carnival, everybody would just dress up like a Disney character or somebody out of a movie or a bear or whatever. It's totally not the same as it is here. What I love about Aruba also is the salsa, because you guys know Mitchell is a salsa instructor. That's how we met. I've also done some salsa teaching here on Aruba together with him. But salsa is just, you go up in the music, and especially with the warm weather here, it's just a perfect combination. And you have the salsa club, you have two salsa dancing schools, all the big clubs, they have like salsa nights. It's just, if you love salsa, you should definitely come to Aruba one time. Mm-mm-mm. Also, the atmosphere here on the island is very relaxed. For example, if you have an appointment with somebody, you can put your clock on it that they will be 10 minutes late or even 15 minutes late. And in the beginning, I really had to get used to that, because in Holland, everybody is on time. And especially me, I've had it from the first school that I went to, I was always 10 minutes early. So if here somebody comes 10 minutes late, I really had to adjust to it. But that's just one example. That just shows how relaxed everybody is. And everything goes a little bit slower. It's like, I don't know, it's just no stress. You have to do everything you have to do in this day, but don't rush it, you know. Rush gives you stress, which makes you make mistakes, just do it relaxed. You don't get stressed and just do it right away good. So that's just how it goes here. Last but not least, what I love is there are loads of activities here on the island because it's just a tourist island. There's so much to do for the tourists. Parties, whatever, whatever, so much. Beach parties, you go in the clubs, go there. Markets, so much to do. And it's not only for the tourists, because if you live here, you have the privilege of going there also. So it's just, there's so much fun. The island is so small, but there's so much to do. Now, there are also some downer sides here on the island. And the biggest one for me, okay. Let's just keep the part that I miss my family and my friends most of all. But this, the things that I'm gonna point out now is more like with the island. So what I miss on this island is the shopping. In Holland you have like two streets behind each other and they are full of shops and all these famous brands and big, big shopping malls and oh my gosh! And I am a girly girl. I love dresses, I love shopping, I love shoes, I love bags. Here on Aruba, the shopping is just one street, and also the shops, they're not all my thing, you know. Some of them are way too expensive, a lot of them are very cheap, but the quality of the clothes is just way less. If you really want to spend some money, I know where the good shops are, but you have to bring your car and you go like, you go there for one shop. Then you drive there for the other good shop, and then you drive there. It's like, it's not close together, so you have to spend like the whole day to spend your money. Also, because it is so hot here on Aruba, you know, when I lived in Holland, and when I would work and I would have a break, I would always take a walk. But if you are on a break here on Aruba, if you work, I don't think taking a walk would be so nice because your armpits, they will be sweaty because it's so hot. And with a baby also, you know, you like to walk around with your stroller. Yeah, it's just so hot during the day. I only go out early in the morning or late in the afternoon. So yeah, of course if you're a tourist you go and lie on the beach. The beach, actually you can go to the beach all the time because you can cool down. But yeah, like walking in Oranjestad, you have to pick your time for that, so. And also, I miss the woods. There's a lot of nature here. It's like more than 30% of Aruba is a nature reserve. It's Park Arikok, which is beautiful with caves and also some kind of beaches and sand dunes. Oh my god, you have like all these brown sand over everywhere in the park, and then you have these white dunes. So cool, so amazing, so beautiful. I'm not trying to get you guys to Aruba, but it is really beautiful. But we don't have like woods, and with all the you hear, all the birds and the squirrels, and you can make long walks. No, if you go and walk here through the woods, like close to the Balashi Gold Smeltery, you have some kinds of woods where mountain bikers drive through, but there's so many mosquitoes. It's like crazy, you can go there. Oh, that's also one thing that I hate. There's so many mosquitoes here on Aruba. But yeah, all of those downer sides, they don't weigh up to all the positive things. And you guys know, the most important thing why I am here on Aruba, or why I stay here on Aruba, because I was planning to go to Aruba for 3 years and then go back to Holland. But yeah, me and Mitchell, we ended up falling so heavenly in love. So yeah, that's the biggest reason I stay here, because I found love, I found Mitchell, I have my baby here. And you know, if you have the right people in your life, it really doesn't matter where you are. Does that make sense to you guys? Well, to me it does. So I'm just so happy here, and I wish I could bring all of you here to Aruba. Maybe living here is not for all of you, but having a vacation here would be very nice. So if you guys are planning on ever going to Aruba, let me know. Sorry for that, but my memory card just got so full because I had so much to mention. Anyway, if you guys are planning on coming to Aruba, or after watching this video you really want to go to Aruba, let me know in a comment right down below. And I'll see you guys next video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, comment, share, and bye guys!